Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Lisa Belinda and I make videos about clean beauty and holistic wellness. In today's video, I'm going to show you my empties and my expired products. I thought this video would be really fun to make because there are some products here that were kind of hyped that I just didn't really enjoy at all. And then there are some products that I didn't really have high expectations of, but I absolutely loved. So I just want to do this video to help you navigate the clean beauty jungle. Hopefully I can help you figure out what's worth spending your money on and what's not. And of course, this is my opinion. Everybody's different. So maybe I hate a product that you absolutely love and vice versa, but hopefully it will be helpful. So let's just get started. Skincare, makeup, and also some hair products. So I'm just gonna go through them one by one. First up is this cleanser from COSRX. I'm not sure if that's how you say it. First time I encountered this brand, I was like, COSRX. But I'm pretty sure that's not how you say it. I think it's COSRX. So this is the low pH Good Morning Gel Cleanser. And I was so excited about this one. This is an empty, by the way. This is completely empty, so I've used it all. So clearly I don't hate it, but I also don't love it. I've read a lot of good reviews about this, and what made me buy it, I was on the lookout for a low pH cleanser. It's very important to wash your face with a low pH cleanser. If your pH balance on your skin is off, it doesn't really matter if you use the best products after. You haven't really laid down a good foundation for those products to be. You're not gonna get the maximum benefit out of those products. So it's really important to keep the pH balance on your skin acidic. That's why I purchased, that's the most difficult word for me to pronounce, purchased. That's why I purchased. That's why I bought this cleanser. It gets the makeup off super nicely. In the evening when I'm wearing makeup or sunscreen, I do a double cleanse. So either I use an oil cleanser before and then use this one, or I just use this one twice. And it does the job, it gets the makeup off. It's a gel cleanser and it foams, which I really like. The problem is that it feels really harsh. Like it feels really detergent-y, if that makes sense. And the foam is, I like a soft, creamy foam, but this is like a foam. When I was like exhaling as I was massaging this on my face, I will blow these huge bubbles. Like it's just, there's some kind of detergent in here that's just, it's too much. It feels too harsh and my skin felt very stripped afterwards. So for that reason, I will not be repurchasing this one. I could say repurchase, but I can't say purchase. But yeah, I don't hate it, I don't love it. So this one, I'm happy I tried it, but I will not be buying it again. Moving on. So the next product is this moisturizer from Starskin or Glamic. And this is the Pink Cactus Pudding. This is such an amazing cream. I still have a little bit left of it, but I'm almost out of it. I love this so much, but I will not be repurchasing it. I will let you know soon. It has like a really amazing texture. It's really like a pudding. It's so lovely in the summer, like it just sinks into the skin. It's not silicone-y at all. It doesn't contain any silicone, but it just kind of plumps the skin and just makes the skin feel really nice and even and super hydrated. But when I purchased this one, I thought that Starskin or Glamic was a cruelty-free brand because that was what the cashier told me, but it's not. I later found out that it's not cruelty-free, and I'm not marketing my channel or my Instagram account or anything as a cruelty-free channel, a cruelty-free account, simply because I just don't want to get in trouble. You know, everybody makes mistakes. Like now, I have even like posted about this on Instagram thinking that it was cruelty-free. So that's why I don't call myself like a cruelty-free creator. However, I care a lot about purchasing only cruelty-free products. I just kind of need to be able to make mistakes. That's why I don't label myself as a cruelty-free creator. But it is very, very important to me. So for that reason, I will not be buying this again. If you know a moisturizer that is from a clean beauty brand that is cruelty-free, then please let me know in the comments because I would love to find a dupe for this one. It's also really, really pricey. If it wasn't for the not cruelty-free, then I would definitely buy it again, no matter how much it cost. The next product is a deodorant. This is the Botanical Cream Deodorant from Aurelia Probiotics. Aurelia Probiotics Skincare. This one is completely empty. This is the best clean deodorant ever. Like it's so, so good. I have a few clean deodorants that I enjoy and that works, but nothing beats this. Like not even an aluminum toxic deodorant can't even beat this. It's so effective and it smells like this fresh mint. It's just so good, and I love that it's a cream because it just feels like more gentle on the armpits. It doesn't dry out the armpits like many other deodorants do. I've already bought a new one. Like I will keep repurchasing this probably for the rest of my life. Like it's that good. Kind of pricey for a deodorant, but in my opinion, so worth it, and it lasts a long time. My husband is also using this. He used to use this like very toxic spray-on deodorants, and I tossed them all and converted him to the clean beauty deodorants. He loves this one, and it works for him so well. And as you can see, I'm not a person that doesn't sweat. Like I sweat like a pig when it's warm outside, so I'm definitely like a good test person for deodorants. This works. And the next product I have is a hair care product. This one is also clearly very empty. This is a hair oil. This is the Revive 5 hair oil from Buclem. I've talked about this one in, I think, more than one video before. It's a very nourishing hair oil. There's nothing left, so I can't show you the consistency, but it's very, very thin, so it doesn't make the hair heavy and greasy. And that's one thing I really love about it, because a lot of hair oils, you have to be so careful. You can't really like get it all over your hair without getting this very greasy, weighed down look. With this one, you can really like get in there and use a lot without weighing your hair down. And also, it's silicone-free, which I know some people don't care about at all. I care about it because I have naturally very curly hair. So I have to really be conscious of the ingredients that I put in my hair to not get this like silicone buildup and to keep my curls healthy and hydrated. And this one does the job so well. The only negative thing that I have to say about it is the pump. This is my third bottle of this. First time I tried it, I thought I just got like a bad bottle, that it was something wrong with it. But it's been like that with all of them. It's just the pump doesn't work properly. This one gets stuck, and then when you try to like pump out the oil, it's just like explodes all over the place. And I have ruined a few of my clothes because of that. So actually I started just like opening this one and like pouring it in my hand, which is not very convenient. Like I really wish they would make a better pump thing. But apart from that, it's really amazing. I will definitely repurchase this one. I'm also curious to try new brands, so I'm like, I'm not gonna purchase this one right away, but it is like one of those holy grail favorites that I keep coming back to. Moving on to makeup. I have this foundation from Juice Beauty. This is the Phytopigments Flawless Serum Foundation. As you can see, it's very like nasty and oily and separated. I used this a couple of times and I didn't hate it at all. Like it's not a bad foundation. I did feel like it was like a little bit greasy and that it tend to lay on top of the skin instead of sinking in. Like it looked really good on camera. I did some nice looks on Instagram and it looks really nice like on picture and on video, but just not in real life. And I need a product that looks good in real life as well. It does contain coconut alkynes. I don't know if that's how you say it, coconut alkynes, which is an emollient derived from coconuts, and it's not as comedogenic as coconut oil, but it is still comedogenic. I found that this one broke me out a little bit, not like full-blown breakout, but it just gave me like little small congested pores, which I kind of struggle with in general, and this one really just made it worse. For that reason, I will not be repurchasing it. If you're not struggling with any type of acne at all, if you have like perfect, flawless skin with like no visible pores, pores, no congested pores, no dry patches, then I'm sure this one will look great on you. But most of us have some kind of skin crap that we're dealing with, and this one is just gonna emphasize all of that, so we'll not be repurchasing. The next product is also from Juice Beauty. This is their Phytopigments Illuminating Primer. This one, it looks like I've barely used it. I have actually used it quite a lot. I don't hate this product. So it's a primer and it's meant to be used like all over your face under your makeup, but I'm gonna show you guys. Like, can you see that? It's just very, very shiny, almost like metallic-y. So I found that when I used this all over my face, it just emphasized pores and texture so much. It did not make my skin look good. So I started actually using it as a primer, like only on the cheek area, because my skin is very smooth and like flawless on the cheek areas. Whereas in my T-zone, there's more texture, pores, etc. And for that, it's really, really nice because it does add this like glow under your foundation. And as a highlighter, it's very subtle. Like if I'm wearing makeup, I wouldn't use this one because although it is like slightly metallic-y and shimmery, it's not enough for a highlighter, I think. But if I'm not wearing makeup, it's like a nice kind of like skincare makeup. And the bottle is huge and it expires within 12 months. And like, if you're not using this on a daily basis all over your face, you're just not gonna finish this jar in a year. Like I've had this in over a year and it looks like I barely touched it. You get a lot of products for the price, but it's also so unnecessary. Like nobody's gonna use this. So although it's not bad, I will not be repurchasing it because there are so many other primers that I enjoy so much more. Also so many highlighters that I also like way better than this. And the next product is one of my absolute favorite holy grail products. This is the Ilia Super Serum Skin Tint. I have talked about this product before. I don't know if I talked about it on my YouTube channel, but I definitely mentioned it a few times on my Instagram. This is the most amazing foundation. I don't even know if you call it a foundation. It's like the coverage is very light, so it's more like a BB cream tinted serum type of thing, but it's so good. It's also very like oily, but it's not like this one. This one I find really sinks in to the skin and blends nicely and like clumps your skin in a way, whereas this one just sits on top. This is my third or fourth bottle of this. This stuff is so good. It's quite pricey, and if you use it on a daily basis, it doesn't last you that long, but it's so worth it. Like, I love it so much, and it has SPF 30. In the EU, I believe it has SPF 30, and in the US, it has SPF 40. I guess it has something to do with like the SPF regulations, but it's still like a high SPF, and I love that you just get that into your makeup. And like I said, it's not like a foundation. If I use a foundation with SPF, I would like to use like a real SPF underneath. With this one, I feel like this one does the job. The coverage is so light, so you can use like a proper amount of it. So this one I will be repurchasing for the rest of my life. It's so good. You have to try it. The next product is another base product. This is the Complexion Rescue Tinted Hydrating Gel Cream from Bare Minerals. I've had this for such a long time. This one is so expired. It's almost full. And this was like the second time I tried it. I just felt like I needed to give it another chance because the first time I did not like it, but my skin also changed a lot. So I thought I'm going to give it a chance. But I mean, it's just been here for like a year now. And whenever I try it, I'm just like, nah. No. First of all, it is a tinted hydrating cream, so it doesn't say that it's going to cover a lot, but it almost doesn't cover at all. It's almost like you could just use a non-tinted moisturizer because this does absolutely nothing. And also, I'm gonna show you, now it's expired, so it's gonna look a little gross. I just put it here on the back of my hand. It doesn't want to blend with the skin. It just kind of sits on top. It's almost like you mixed water and oil. It just doesn't want to blend properly. It's not nice. It's like mattifying, almost like a little bit metallic in a way, and a slight gray tone. I feel like all of the shades have like a slight gray tone, so you look like the freaking Tin Man. Like, it's not pretty. It's just not. I love a healthy, dewy glow. I do not like the combination of matte and shimmery at the same time, if that makes sense. It's just, I don't like it. And I've heard a lot of people who absolutely absolutely love this one and swear by it, but it's not for me. Of course, it has to do with your skin. Like I said, if you have perfect, flawless skin, then this one will probably look good on you. But even then, you will still look great. No, it's bad. I do not recommend. All right, let's move on to the next product. This is a product that I've talked about in a previous video when I did my Era Perez review. This is their Cranberry Lip and Eye Butter. So this is a eye cream and a lip balm. This one is an empty, like I've absolutely scraped out this jar. Like I've used every single drop of it. It's actually really lovely, but I'm not sure if I will repurchase it. I use it only as an eye cream. I think I had this product in my 2020 favorites video where I mentioned this as well. On the lips, it feels a bit weird. Like I love a lip balm. I'm absolutely like addicted to a good lip balm, but I like more like an oily like lip balm stick. This is more like a solve, if that makes sense. It's also not like a thick cream. It's kind of like light and whipped in a way, which feels very weird on the lips. It feels a bit cold, like you want to wipe it off. So I don't use it on my lips. But as an eye cream, it's very lovely. I love the packaging. It looks so cute. Just having it like on the counter or on your bedside table or in your purse. And you can also use this if you have any dry areas like cuticles or your elbows. I've even used it to define my eyebrows and to brush them in place. And it's very nice for that. It's a very versatile product. But I just feel like there are a lot of other eye creams that are more active, that does a better job, if that makes sense. This is very basic. It's a lovely product and it feels very nice when you apply it, but it's not gonna minimize dark circles or puffiness. It will help with dryness if you're dry around the eyes, but apart from that, it's not gonna really... So I don't think I will repurchase it. I've loved it, but I feel like there are so many more fish at sea. I think if I were to like find this in a store, I might buy it, but I don't think there's any store in Denmark that carry Era Perez. So for me to sit down and order it, I don't think that's gonna happen. But I also have to recommend it because it is good. If you're going on a trip, if you're going out hiking, like you just want to bring minimum amount of products, but you need something that can do a lot of things, this one is great. So I would say that would be a reason for me to buy it again. If I was going on a trip where I couldn't bring too many things, then this is actually a very good product. But I'm far from a minimalist when it comes to makeup and skincare. I am an absolute hoarder. Moving on. The next product is a lip balm slash lip gloss. I've talked about this one before as well. This is the Kiss My Liquid Lip Balm from Rowan Beauty. And I have the shade Charlie. As you can see, this one is very, very empty. And I don't think I have ever finished a gloss before. Like, that's never happened because there are so many different ones. I like to vary between different glosses and I just never use them completely before they're expired. But this one, there's still a little bit in the bottom and I'm just like scraping out every day. It's just so good because it's so unique. Like I said, it's a hybrid between a lip balm and a lip gloss. So it doesn't have that stickiness that most glosses do. And it's just so hydrating on the lips. And this shade is just like a my lips but better kind of shade. Just looks like you've been out in the cold and your lips are turning like a little bit red. Or you know like when, okay, you know when you burn your lips? And then before they turn like really dry and not very nice, like when you just come home after a day and you've realized that you've burned your lips, they're like nice and red and defined, a little bit pouty, and you enjoy that for like an hour before they turn absolutely dry. That's what this one gives. It's just so nice. I need to buy a new one. I actually ordered one of their new shimmery glosses that I'm very curious to try, but I need to repurchase this exact shade from the original collection because it is amazing. If you haven't tried this, you should. This is not like any other product. It's so unique. Definitely will be repurchasing this one. I'm almost done. Just a few more products. Then we have this brow gel. Actually, I don't know what it's called, but it's just a brow gel from Juice Beauty. I believe they only have one type of brow gel. And this is the shade medium. And this is just, this one is almost full. Like I tried with this one. It's just, I mean, this brush, do you see that? It's just so tiny. Like it doesn't do anything. and it makes it so hard to apply this product evenly. You just get like a lot of product. This tiny brush just doesn't distribute it nicely at all. What I did with this one is I would just take like a slanted brush and just dip it in there and then like paint in my brows, and that worked okay, but like that's not what I get a brow gel for. Then I could just get like a brow pomade or something else instead. So do not recommend this one, it's really bad. Next one is the most amazing concealer of all time. This is the True Skin Serum Concealer from Ilia. As you can see, this one is also like completely empty. I have really like scraped out every single drop of this. It's just so lovely, especially now in summer. I just want something that's very light on the skin. And this one, it's not full coverage. Like I would say it's a medium coverage, but it's just, it's so good. It blends so nicely with the skin, and it's good both under your eyes, but also like to cover up any spots or redness or whatever. And I love that it doesn't look cakey. Like if you have a spot or redness around your nose, you can just apply this one and it doesn't look cakey. It just blends in with your skin. You can use it on top of makeup, you can use it by yourself. There's actually a lot of concealers that I find don't look very good by themselves. It looks like patchy, but this one is just blending so nicely with the skin. Like you don't have to have your entire face covered in makeup in order to use this one. You can just dot it wherever you need to and you're good to go. Ugh. It's so good. It also contains vitamin C, and I actually feel when I use this, I had a breakout on my chin and I got a lot of redness hyperpigmentation, and I used this one to cover it up and it didn't like cover it completely. You can still see some redness, but I didn't mind. I just wanted like cover most of it, and I found that the redness faded so quickly, which I'm guessing is because of the vitamin C in this product. And of course my skincare also played a role in that, but I think it's nice when your makeup is like skincare infused and has like skin benefiting ingredients. And that's what I love about Ilia in general, especially with this concealer. I have the shade SC1 Chicory, which is a little bit too light for me to cover up spots and stuff. Like it's a little too light to use on my face, but it's perfect to brighten up like under my eyes. We'll be buying forever and ever. And the next product is a mascara. This is the Caution Extreme Lash Mascara from Hourglass. This mascara is so hyped and I was so excited to try it. I watched a lot of YouTube videos before I bought it because I thought it was kind of pricey for a mascara. In most of those videos, people just loved it and raved about it. So I was like, okay, I need to get this. But I was very disappointed. So this is what the brush looks like. Like a very basic brush, I would say. I usually prefer a brush that's a little bit more unique. I feel like this is a very basic brush. I just felt like this one made my lashes very clumpy. And I have quite long lashes, but they're also like all over the place. They're wild. And sometimes I can have like a lash pointing like downward and like, I mean upward. They always point upward. So I need a mascara that has a brush that really catches the lashes and like defines them. This one doesn't do that. It adds volume, absolutely. Volume and length, but it just looks very, on me, very spidery and cakey, and I do not enjoy it. It looks really nice though. Like it's so heavy and luxurious. Now it's long expired, but I'm just gonna like keep it here just because it looks nice. Like I said, I am an absolute makeup hoarder. All right, moving on to the last products. I have the Pro Eyelash Serum from XLash, and then I also have their Eyebrow Conditioner. Here I have mixed opinions. The Lash Serum I have used for many years. It is amazing, and I owe my long lashes to this one 100%. I naturally have not short lashes, but just normal, basic lashes. But with this eyelash serum, my lashes have grown so much. I use it almost every night. Sometimes I forget. I forget quite a lot, but I use it before I go to bed. It does make the skin a little bit dark. It's almost like I always have a bit of an eyeliner, which I don't mind. It doesn't irritate my eyes, and this one doesn't contain a lot of these harmful ingredients that many other eyelash serums do. I don't know what ingredient it is, but there is one ingredient that's, for example, in Revitalash that actually changes the color of your eyes. This one does not contain that. And of course, it contains a lot of ingredients that I don't really know what it is, but I did my research before buying this, and I even emailed the brand asking them what the different ingredients were and how it was different from other brands, and they answered very detailed. So I felt confident to keep using this, and I haven't had any issues with with it at all. It just makes my lashes grow so long. I get so many compliments for my lashes. The other week I got a compliment from the sales person at Sephora. She was asking me if I have eyelash extensions. That's a question I get so often, if I have eyelash extensions. I don't, I've never tried them. So I always tell everybody that it's because of this serum. I don't know how many people I've gotten to buy this serum now. I'm not affiliated with the brand, but I feel like I should be because I've generated a lot of sales for them, I'm pretty sure. And then from the same brand, we have the brow serum. And this one just does not work for me. It just doesn't do anything at all for me. It makes like your existing brows thicker, like more coarse and like longer, which I'm not sure if you really want. For me, it didn't really make more brows grow out. Now I filled in my brows so you can't really see what's missing. My brows are very thin, like here at the end. I went to a salon to get them waxed and like nice and fluffy, and she just removed way too much and they haven't grown out since. So the lesson of that is never let anyone, no matter how professional they are, touch your brows. You can pluck them yourself. Don't let anyone touch your brows. Oh, I talk too much. So yeah, I was really hoping for this one to work since the eyelash serum worked so well. It doesn't work for me, sadly. Maybe it works for someone else, but not for me. So I'm going to continue my search to find a good eyebrow serum to really get my fluffy brows back. All right, that was all of the products I had to show you. I really hope that this video was helpful and that it helped you figure out what products you want to spend your money on and what products you don't even want to waste your time on. And of course, this is very individual and this is just my opinion, but hopefully it will help you navigate the beauty jungle a little easier. Please let me know in the comments if you've tried any of these products. It would be so nice to hear. I'm so curious to hear if you have a different opinion about any of these products. And of course, as always, give me recommendations if there's any product that you think I would like that you want me to try. Now I'm going to go take a shower because I am melting. I really hope that you enjoyed this video. If you did, please don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and ring the bell so that you can stay notified when I upload a new video. I will see you in my next video, and until then, as always, stay glowing!